Now let me talk to you about, first of all, this is not going to be a short, it's going to be a 10-minute video. Because the absence of your father, you haven't been taught to have patience. So let me talk about. Now because the father is the head, as he goes, so goes the household. And as the household goes, so goes society. You see, the benevolent presence of a father results in a more orderly and more fruitful life. That's a fact, bro. His absence, whether it's by distance or abdication, it results in disorder and chaos without a father. There are all sorts of psychological reasons for the power of fathers, but they all boil down to the simple reality that human fathers image of Yahweh, God the Father, just as Yahusha, the Son, is a representation and radiance of God and upholds all things by the word of his power, as it says in Hebrews 1:3. So men, the image and glory of God, as spoken of in 1 Corinthians 11:7, they uphold their families, they uphold their houses, and their societies by the power entrusted to them, to you men. So when any woman that says, I don't need a man, is on a path for destruction, in accordance with the word of the Most High. You see, the collapse that we face today is primarily caused by clueless bastards who don't know how to be fathers. Uphold of order, they don't know. And they don't know this because they've never had fathers. 80% are raised by women. Or put another way, they've not been sons. It's impossible to be good fathers without first learning to be a good son. See, Adam was made to take up the fatherly work of Yahuwah God. This is what it means to be a son at a fundamental level, in accordance with John, Yochanan 5:19-20. John 8:28, John 14:10. See, a son represents his father, and thus, the most important aspect of his sonship is becoming a father himself. And his fatherhood is passed down from generation to generation, from Yahuwah, God, to Adam, to his sons, Genesis 5:3, and all the way to us. Somebody can feel me right now. I'm talking to somebody right now, and you really need to hear me, because you got to stand up and be men again. See, it is the nature, it's the natural chain by which Yahuwah trains up young men to take over the work of their fathers as fathers, and to continue his image into the world, establishing order and upholding society, exercising dominion. A break in the chain of one house can be catastrophic to the house's son. So you got 80% of families with women raising them. It's catastrophic to the sons and daughters. The son who holds themselves thundering to represent God in the world, not having learned to be sons, man. So therefore, they can't be fathers. But a break in the chain for a whole nation, for an entire nation of houses, is catastrophic for society itself. What do you mean you don't need a man? A culture that seeks to smash the patriarchy, that seeks to destroy father rule, is therefore a culture that seeks its own annihilation. Understand that. So the closer it gets to removing the image of Yahuwah God in the father rule, the closer it becomes to unraveling. The father, it emulates the means by which Yahuwah orders and upholds the human world. See, the father, it descends into chaos when they move away from father rule. Without that mechanism by which Yahuwah exercises his dominion over the human world, it can no longer do the work of of Yahuwah. Divide it, shape it, fill it. It becomes a society of abortions, of butch women, of effeminate men, of gay pride, a belief in gender fluidity, and of every other degrading doctrine that now blurs together that which from the beginning of Yahuwah had separated. See, patriarchy or death, that's my aphorism, and that's Yahuwah's, God's aphorism. Patriarchy or death, it's not a glib catchphrase. It's a seed of vital truth. See, young men today are unwitting, unwilling of a culture of death. They are clueless bastards in dire need of fathers. They do not know how to image Yahuwah God. And so they don't know how to mature into wise, strong men. So is it too late to adopt? Your father failed you in whatever way. And now you're stuck being will hunting. Perpetually trying to learn from books or blogs on YouTube, on social media platforms. No. Yahuwah has provided fathers. And unfortunately, many clueless bastards are looking in the wrong place. You can't learn to be a father from social media. You can't learn to be a man from social media. They're trying to fill the father void by turning to teachers who promise knowledge rather than to fathers who will disciple them into wisdom. See, they want easily obtained learning rather than hard-won patriotical wisdom. They're eager to exercise authority without themselves being placed under authority. You understand what I'm talking about? They're like Simon the magician, seeking to gain the power of Yahuwah through money, when they should be like the Hebrews, seeking to gain the holiness of Yahuwah through chastening. If you endure chastising, Yahuwah deal with you as sons. For what son is he whom the father chastiseth not? You understand what I'm talking about? But if you are without chastisement, then you are bastards and not sons. Book of Hebrews 12, 7 and 8. See, by turning to gods rather than to fathers, they are all doing what comes naturally, unwittingly, seeking to remain bastards. They don't see the value and becoming sons, because in their case, they cannot relate to the verses that follow. Hebrews 12, 9 through 10. You understand what I'm talking about? You got to stand up and be men again. You got to stop bending over. You got to learn to be real men. Father is the backbone of society. The society is in a degenerate condition because of the absence of real fathers. The philosophy that women has taken on, saying, I don't need a man, is bringing about a swift destruction to the society as a whole. Take a look around. You wonder where you can't find a man? I'm talking to you, sister. I'm talking to you right now. It's because he didn't have a father. Get your mind right, queen. Get your mind right, king. The Father. Most High gave you the solution at the last book in the Old Testament. He said, to fix the society, you got to turn the hearts of the fathers to the children and the children to the father, in the book of Malachi 4, verse 6. And then when he comes back in the so-called New Testament, he goes and get 12 men to fix the world. Heed the knowledge. Go on, tell the dark so you know, set it. This one over your head, listen to it another 10 times. This is right knowledge revealed. This is straight from the heart. The Father is essential. It's a fabric of society. It was destruction. Patriarch